All right, so today is not a long story kind of thing. These are some quick wins, independent of each other. How can we deliver results and benefits very quickly, immediately out of the box, with no programming, no configuration, nothing, based on Office 365, of course. So what is this? So I talked about Teams yesterday. Teams is the application which is a part of Office 365. You get it even if you have the even license. Now, one of the most popular features in Teams has no special functionality as such. It has been always there, called org chart. How many of you have seen that in Teams? Org chart. It's a very popular feature. Many people don't know. Even those who use Teams don't know about it. All that you have to do is go to Teams chat, type a name of a person, and when you see the name of the person, you will see an org chart icon. Click on that, or start a chat and there is an organization tab. Click on that. What do you see then? You see the entire org chart beautifully rendered, and this is interactive. You can click on any name and it will go and show the hierarchy upwards as well as downwards, from topmost to the lowest level. This information is automatically picked up from Active Directory. In terms of functionality, is not new. Even on Outlook this was possible, but it was not laid out as a nice org chart. And once you find someone, what can we do? We can chat, we can send a mail, VoIP or video. So it's a very convenient and very popular feature. So many users start using Teams just because of this feature, and then they expand further. So start using it. It's out of the box. Kaizala I mentioned yesterday, so for those who were not there, Kaizala allows you to have unlimited people in a chat group. Every message which is in the chat is archived, like we archive emails for regulatory purposes. And most importantly, it works on a mobile phone with the phone number as the login, if you like, or it can integrate with Active Directory. So you can have a public group for customers or third parties and have a private group for your organization. Having done that, it's a platform for automation. So you can actually create forms, surveys, action cards without programming within Kaizala, and the same chat client, so to say, can serve multiple purposes. I was just talking to one of my friends today, and they are using it for capturing ATM maintenance stuff. So when people, the engineer goes to an ATM, connects, manages the stuff, they have to fill a form. That form comes as a chat. It also requires you to capture a photograph, so it has a built-in photo app plus GPS coordinates capability. And to prevent fudging or misuse, it forces you to use the camera. You can't upload a pre-existing photo. So like this, you can even program a little and integrate with your line of business applications. So out of the box, you get a mobile platform which is very, very fast to implement functionality. I'm not going to show you a demo of that. Let's start with something in AI. We have been talking about artificial intelligence a lot. Now, typically it is talked about in terms of business applications and analytics, but let me show you how even PowerPoint is using AI. So this is a common problem. I have put multiple photos and I need to arrange them. I'm sure all of you have wasted precious time of life trying to rearrange, crop, align, and figure out a aesthetically compelling arrangement. After spending 15 minutes on it, it still looks bad, but we have wasted time. So now what happens is you just put the photos, go to design tab, and there is a button called design ideas. You need an internet connection for this. It will think about it. It will understand how many images are there, what is the layout of the slide, and it will automatically generate multiple options for you. This is AI in action. This is out of the box. This will work only with Office Pro Plus, and it requires an internet connection. Now, extending the same thought further, many times we create some bullets, and sometimes we may want to convert it to a smart ad, which I'm sure all of you do. So maybe I can do this and create some diagrams. But now things have gone beyond that. Without you having to choose the correct type of diagram, because there are 145 of them, you need to know all the 145 to choose the right one in the right place. What does it do? I have just typed bullets here. Again, I go to the same button called design ideas. And what does it do? It actually created multiple options for me. It actually created a timeline for me. This is a simple thing, but it also does something else. Let me show you that. Notice what it did in this case. It found the relevant icon for that text. It understood the text, found the clip art library, and found the correct icon for it. So this is a quick way of creating better looking slides without wasting time. All right, now coming to AI in Excel. How many of you have used a feature called Ideas? What we saw just now was design ideas in PowerPoint. Similarly, there is an Ideas feature in Excel. How many have used it? Nobody. All right. So let me show you. This simple data, transactional data, each row is a transaction, single table, very simple. Normally, we'll create pivot tables, analyze the data and stuff like that. Now, typically what happens, based on this data, how many reports will get created depends on the norms in the company. What are the reports being requested by someone? We make those many reports. So let's say for this data, we are making 5 reports. Does it mean the data does not have a 6th equally useful piece of information? Or 7th or 8th or 9th? Maybe it has. But because nobody asked for that report, nobody looked at that piece of information. And a potentially useful piece of information was lost. Nobody acted on it. It's a loss of opportunity. So all the data, whatever tool you use, is underutilized from this point of view. We don't have the capability of finding all the possible useful things from a given piece of data. We only go by what is asked for, deliver that. It's fulfillment. It's not full utilization. Now, how do you do that? If I decide to spend time, what will I do? I really want to look at all the permutations, combinations of the data. So probably I will create a pivot table and keep adding multiple fields in multiple permutations and combinations and try to check, is this data telling me something useful? Technically it is possible, but it's time consuming. You don't know which permutation combination will give you useful information. So now there is a new feature available. This is still in beta, but if you have Office Pro Plus, you should get this button. So you don't need to have any operation applied to the data, just have raw data. Go to Home tab, you'll see an Ideas button. When you click on that button, this requires an internet connection. What it does is, it uploads the data to Microsoft Azure AI servers, temporarily, encrypted of course, and it deletes it afterwards. And that AI engine analyzes your data. Your AI engine does not understand whether what is location or what is city or what is silver card or gold card. It understands text, number and dates. So it statistically analyzes all permutation combinations, finds out the interesting or useful ones, and then it presents those to you on a platter. So now notice, it has looked at my data and it is giving me some information. For example here, silver card accounts for majority of last transactions. Now that is not all. It has found 36 potentially useful things from my data. 100% I am never going to create 36 reports out of this data, but this guy has already done it for me. So when I scroll down, look at what kind of information it is giving me. Let's look at one of them. Notice in Calcutta, card type silver has noticeably higher cashback. Now to show me this particular visual, it had to look at all cities, all types of cards, all cashbacks, and then find this was statistically important or significant. It depends on either p-value or r-square, depending on the operation applied. But you don't have to understand statistics. You don't have to do permutation combination. It's giving it to you on a platter. Another one, look at this. Card type silver, gender female, has 4 outliers in cashback. Now what is this? This is a pivot chart. What do I have? Raw data. So if I want to investigate this further, I say insert pivot chart. In which case it will create a pivot table, it will create that chart, it will format it for you. Why am I showing this particular example? Because this is a date column. In any report which you create, in any tool, when there is a date column, you never create a report which shows every date. You will always summarize it by week, month, quarter. So even if you use whichever tool, highly unlikely that you will see date wise. but this guy did it and it has spawned 4 abnormal transactions. Now you can investigate what happened on 12 Jan. So like this, without lifting your finger, you are getting useful information on platter. All that is required is click on that button. So now, noticing that button and clicking on that button for every piece of information every user has should become a standard operating procedure. With no extra effort, you will find additional actionable information from the same old data which you have been having with you for years. So that's a very, very powerful feature. There's another new feature which was recently added, I think 10 days back, on Excel Mobile. So what does it do? On Excel Mobile, there is a new button added. This button, this is called import from camera or import from photo. So what do? You take a picture of anything which has tabular data on it, just a printout. Handwriting doesn't work as of now, it will come soon. But as of now, it has to be tabular data on a picture. Once you take the picture, it will analyze the data and it will try to find and convert it using OCR. Some of it is confident about, some of it is not confident about, which you can review and edit. And finally, you get the data in Excel. Again, really useful feature. Maybe you already have the app installed, but you didn't know this feature was added. So very recent feature, so update your app if you want to use it. Okay, going further, we have very nice 3 important new additions to Power BI. How many of you use Power BI? Some of you. Okay, for those who don't use it, it's free to start with. Everything which I'm showing you is available in the free version. Now, many of you, if you go to your finance team, they will say that a lot of data they have to copy paste from PDF files into Excel for doing something else. That now can be managed very easily because now in Power BI, there is a data source called PDF file. Of course, the data cannot be a scanned picture. It has to be text, but copy pasting a table from PDF to Excel does not work. It loses the layout. So this is how it works. On the left side, I have some data, which is publicly available from a PDF file. And on the right side, I chose that as the data source. So what has it done? It has gone through and analyzed the PDF file, found out how many tables are there. It is showing me the table on that particular page. As you can see, it has already cleaned up that data, already found columns, but I need to do some things because I want the first row to be taken as header. I don't want these 2 rows. Some cleanup is required. So I can do that cleanup by saying edit. And I'm not going to show you the entire editing sequence, but actually I had to take few steps to clean up the data. This is done through a UI. You don't have to manually type any code. And once the data is clean, you can import it in Power BI. Now, once the data is in Power BI, you can combine it with other pieces of data and analyze it. So PDF as a data source is only available in Power BI. It is not available in Excel. But having said that, Excel has a great feature which most people have not noticed, which has been added around 5 years back. When you go to data in Excel, earlier we used to have get external data. Now that menu has changed to get and transform data. This will dramatically save the time your entire organization spends on importing and cleaning up data. Please explore this and teach it to your users. I'll give you only one example, but before I go there, I'll just show you the data sources which are supported. Hundreds of data sources are there. All these are out of the box. All these are free. You don't pay anything for any connector. This is a part of Excel. Now, having done that, there are some very useful sources here. One of the most common is from folder. Irrespective of what we do in life, even today people are wasting time putting some files in a folder, manually opening the files and consolidating data. That can be completely automated using this option. Saves hours of time. I'm not going to show you a demo, but just notice and use that feature. Okay, the last thing I want to show, which is the most interesting probably, is this. So now, what do? We make reports, we copy paste them in PowerPoint, go into a conference room, in a review meeting, show those to people, and then people ask you questions. For example, if I showed you this data, what would be the most obvious question here? Why was there a sudden drop from whatever, May to June, from 49,000 to 23,000? Now this is, remember, a picture in PowerPoint. The data may be there somewhere, but to answer, what is the most common answer if this question is asked? Why is there a decrease from May to June? What is the most common answer? Right? You may have the data, you may have the capability, you may have the tool, but nobody has the time to do it in front of everyone in that room. So now how to eliminate this question is called digital transformation. So what do? I'm actually going to show you a live thing here. It's the same data. This is Power BI. Now what do? I don't say I'll get back to you. I go to that point which dropped down, right click there and say analyze, explain the decrease. So instead of asking a human being why this happened, you ask the system. Now, in order to understand why this decreased, let's understand the data first. So I have two things plotted, the amount and date, but I also have other pieces of information. Which card type was used, what was the type of expense, gender, age, whatever. And we have city as well. Now, when I say explain the decrease, I have to explain why the amount decreased in terms of one of these other parameters. Now, typically, which answer will you give depends on the business, what is expected by boss, and so on. So now with that in mind, let's do this. So I right click, I say explain the decrease, and now notice what it does. It says there was a 53% decrease, and if you consider age as a factor for that decrease, we have different age groups. Now these people from age 42, 39, 49 contributed the maximum to that decrease of 50%. Now it goes through the states. What is it saying now? Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh has contributed maximum to that decrease. Next, it is saying if you go city level, these are the cities which are contributing to it. All are decreased, but these are the majority of the decrease. Like this, it actually applies this to every other field available, very, very statistically significant, and gives you the output. And if you like one of them, and if you want to investigate it further, what do? You just click on the plus sign here, it becomes a part of your report. So next time onwards, you can monitor it by just refreshing the data. So this is called explain the decrease. It also has a nice new visualization, Power BI. This is a typical stack bar chart. All of you can recognize it. There is a new type of visualization. I strongly suggest whenever you use a stack bar chart, use this chart. This is called a ribbon chart. It looks weird, but look at the difference. What is happening here? In the first month, fuel was contributing and food was contributing highest. But in the second month, the contribution of fuel has gone down and the contribution of the purple one, healthcare, has increased. This we can't really recognize here very easily because there are too many items. But in a ribbon chart, you can actually see that this went to the fourth rank. So stacked bar chart with ranking is called ribbon chart. Start using it. With no extra effort, it gives you additional information. And the last thing, do I have time or finish? Little, okay. Last thing, very quickly, this is an implementation of AI. So we have a new visualization here in Power BI called key influencers. So for example, I have a set of data. I have a lot of data from customers. And each customer has given me a rating. So what happens is, I want to analyze what rating customer has given. And if the rating is high or low, if it is high or low, which parameters influence high or low rating? How do that? So I use key influencers as the visualization. Let me do it on a new page. Key influencers, and what do I want to analyze? The rating, so I put it there. And then I drag drop other parameters which may be influencing that thing. So I'm going to put, let's say, theme, and I'm going to put country, and so on. So you can put multiple parameters there. I'm also going to put role in organization. Now notice what it does. It doesn't draw a regular chart. What it does is it creates this kind of visual. So what is it showing right now? It's saying that if the organization role is publisher, theme is price, country is Germany, these are the ways in which you will get high rating. So this is explaining why this high rating came and how much each factor is contributing to it. Of course, it applies a lot of AI behind the scenes, but you can use it directly. And lastly, it also segments this, saying it found two segments by rating. And if you click on the segment, it will actually give you the breakup. So if saying role being publisher has 95% influence on this, if it is low, then it will change the visual. So start using this out of the box, no programming, and you will start getting better understanding of the same data. So I guess I have to finish. And the last slide is, do we have time for questions or finish? Offline, okay, no problem. So that's it for now. Thank you.